ever wondered why there are so many variations of colors of eggs in birds? You'll find white, brown, and colors in between when it comes to chickens. Some birds have blue colored eggs, and some even have lime green colored eggs. And even for birds of the same breed, for example, my chickens inside here, when you look at the eggs on a tray, you'll notice that the variations of color on one tray are so huge. Why the hell does that happen? Well, in today's video, we're going to be talking about that. So let's get into the chicken house and first take a look at the actual act of laying eggs. This that I have over here is a chicken house that carries 2,500 chickens. All of them are birds of the same breed. It's a breed that we call Issa Brown. And inside there, they lay eggs for me. They have the potential to lay up to 90%, even 95% in terms of egg production. That means that for every 100 chickens, every day, you'll get 95 to 96 eggs. That's crazy! What that means is that an egg is formed inside a chicken every 26 hours. Can you imagine? An egg every 26 hours. I think that's really crazy. Well, we're going to go and check them out. So there's birds on the lower floor right here and birds on the upper floor. So I think for today we're going to go to top floor. Come on guys, let's get there. So this right here is a foot bath to prevent introduction of disease inside the chicken house. So every time someone is going in, you need to step your foot inside there. There's a disinfectant inside there, which is very effective. So we'll move up the ramp, guys. Move up the ramp. So here are our chickens, guys. You can see them. Very happy to see me. You see this act right here? This is a bird that's laying an egg. It's showing that it's docile. When it goes down, it's literally asking to be mounted, you know? Because the whole purpose of laying eggs is for reproduction. The egg is supposed to be fertilized. The chicken will go down, lay its egg, and that egg is supposed to be incubated. You know, it's supposed to sit on the egg and then produce babies from the eggs. But we human beings have chosen to eat the chicken eggs. So for that reason, there is no males inside here. On my breeder farm, you'll notice that I do have males inside the chicken houses because those eggs are fertilized and those eggs we do incubate and hatch out and get chicks. But these chickens over here, the eggs are not incubated. These ones are eggs that are eaten. So they are not fertilized. So you can see that the chickens are very curious, pecking on my overall, pecking on my gumboots, and that's why the gumboots need to be disinfected, because they'll peck on them. That's why the overall needs to be clean. It's not tucked in nicely here, I'll tuck it in. That's why the overall needs to be clean, because if the overall comes with a disease, you'll see the chickens pecking on me. Do you see them pecking on the gumboots? Yeah? So they'll peck on the gumboots, they'll peck on the overall, and if it comes in with a disease, you've already introduced a disease. Right here, you can see the birds feeding. So this is our Issa Brown chickens feeding. So these are our feeders. You see a whole line of feeders right here. And the birds are busy enjoying their food. And here you can see a line of drinkers. So they certainly drink less than they feed. You know, they only drink when they are thirsty. When the food is available, they'll try to eat as much as possible. So this is the drinker right here. And I have my colleague right there doing our daily job of turning the litter inside the chicken house. If we can get closer, you'll notice that, look at all these birds being docile. You know, when you get close to them, they all go down. Have you seen that? Yeah? Let's try. You know? You've seen that, you know? Get close to another. Have you seen that? So when you get close to them, they go down like, you know, they want to be mated. Have you seen that? Yeah? But, hey, I'm not a rooster, so I won't do anything to them. But if you take a look at our litter right here, we have quite a huge amount of litter. We might actually need to decrease it because I think it's becoming too heavy for the chicken house. Oh my God, it's too much. It's too much. Look at all this. Look at how deep I've had to dig in order to check it out. So I think it's becoming too heavy for the chicken house. I'm going to have to slowly reduce it by putting it in bags and taking it on the outside, yeah? To make sure that it's not heavy on the chicken house, because this chicken house, as you can see, is supported from poles, yeah? And if we leave too much weight over here, it might become disastrous. Now, this is our laying boxes, where the actual act of laying eggs takes place. And as you can see, those are chickens inside there. They enter right there to lay their eggs. You can see them. So if we place our hands inside some of the laying boxes, we should be able to get some eggs. For example, you know. Let's go right here. Oh yeah. So, as you can see, I've managed to get 3 eggs. Now these 3 eggs are almost the same color. But as you can see, they're not actually the same color. They have small, tiny variations. There's another one right here. We'll pick it. I think this one is significantly different from the others. Yeah? So let's put back maybe some of the eggs, as I can't hold all of them in one hand. So the way in which eggs are produced is that every day, an ovum is released from the ovaries of the eggs. Ideally, an ovum is what will form the yolk, because the yolk is the core of the egg. That's where the baby or the chick is going to come from. The gall, you know, the yolk, the yellow nice thing that bees in the middle, it comes from the ovum. And once that is produced from the ovary, it goes into the oviduct and it starts the path of going out to form an egg. Now, the whole idea is that everything else that covers the yolk is there to just support the yolk. The shell is there to protect everything on the inside. Then the white part of the egg, which is on the inside, is there to nourish the egg, so that when the egg is being incubated during the 21 days on which a chicken sits on the eggs, and you know, the chick is forming, it has where to feed from to get nutrients and all those other things for the yolk, for the baby that's being formed. So what happens is that once an ovum is produced and it's moving through the oviduct, over the course of about 24 to 26 hours, an entire egg is formed. Can you imagine how crazy that is? An entire egg is formed in just 26 hours. That's crazy, very crazy. But then you might wonder, why is it then that chickens have different colors of shells? Well, the color of the shell is simply a pigment, and there are a lot of myths. They will usually say that depending on the color of the earlobe of the chicken, you can predict the color of the egg. Now, for me over here, all my chickens have red earlobes. Take a look at these chickens. All their earlobes are red. Maybe some of them have a white pigment on the earlobes. And maybe the ones with a white pigment, maybe you see this one, the earlobe has a bit of a white pigment. This one is properly red. This one also has a bit of a white pigment. And then this one, well, yeah, so some of them have white pigments. Some of them is typically red. For example, that one is only red. So they have different colors. You know, some of them are just red and others have a bit of a white pigment on the earlobe. Take a look at that. You can see the white pigment on the earlobe, you know, right besides the ear. I hope I can help you guys tell what the earlobe is. So the earlobe is this right here. Yeah, that's the earlobe. And you can see that this one, for example, has a small, tiny white pigment on what would ideally be a red earlobe. So maybe, just maybe, the different pigments of the earlobe might actually be something that you can use to guess what the eggshell would look like. But the idea is that when an egg is being formed and it's moving through the oviduct, it goes through different stages. And the first stage is where an eggshell is actually put on the outside. And the eggshell has a pigment, and different chickens produce different colors of the pigment, and that will determine the color of the egg that goes into the shell. For the birds that produce blue-shelled eggs, and for the birds that produce green-shelled eggs, it's because they have, you know, green or blue pigments inside them, and that will determine, you know, the different color for the chicken. So as you can see there, we're turning the litter, and guys, like I said, this is a daily routine. Turning the litter inside the chicken house is ideally a daily routine, because you need to make sure that the litter doesn't cake. If you can see right here, yeah, the litter is not caked. You understand? It's quite an amount of litter, honestly. I think it has become too much. We're going to have to reduce it, you know, just a little bit, and put wood shavings, a little bit more wood shavings. But I think it's becoming too much because the chickens produce droppings every day, and that's going to weigh down our structure, which is not a nice idea. So yes, guys, our chickens are producing their eggs right now. As you can see, we have, you know, various laying boxes inside the chicken houses, and inside all of them, the chickens are producing, you know, eggs. So we get quite a number of eggs from this chicken house, for example, both the top and the bottom. And if you would love to understand how I turn these chickens into egg-laying monsters that produce hundreds and thousands of chicken eggs every day, you can watch this video right here. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Catch you very soon with another video. Bye-bye.